Story time! I don't even know what to call this. You think the NSA is going to be cool with this, or... I don't even know. This story has haunted me my entire life. I feel like I've been running from the law for so long. Story. True story. Funny. I mean, I guess it's funny. I never really thought it was funny. LOL. Humor. LMAO. Relatable? Relatable is definitely the wrong name. So you know how everyone has a story? Like, the story? Like, if you're at a party and someone turns to you and says,
"Tell the story."
And you know exactly what it means. The story. Well, I have a story. And unlike most good stories, it involves three key components. Barack Obama, pre-2008 Reebok sneakers, and the absolute earth-shattering horror you only feel after making the worst mistake of your life. So here we go. It all began 8 years ago. I was a gangly child then. And Barack Obama came to town.
When I was a young girl, I attended the presentation of Barack Obama.
Barack Obama.
Except it wasn't a city where my parents worked. And my mother was hired to take pictures of Obama shaking hands with others.
Rich people, CEOs, people that don't wear Reeboks to meet the President of the United States.
So I skipped school to see Obama.
Naturally.
But my teacher was a Republican, so it still counted as an absence.
And the adventure begun. But as I soon learned, most of the adventure was waiting in a large room with my mother and a Secret Service man for roughly 8 hours. Because there's no timing with Obama.
Barack Obama.
No one can know when Obama's supposed to be there.
Barack Obama.
There's no, like, Obama warning system.
Barack.
It's just that one second, he's not there, and the next second, he's there.
Barack Obama.
So, it was 8 hours, and I remember nothing from those 8 hours, except for when one of the Secret Service men tried to talk to me.
How are your studies?
He said.
How's school?
He probably meant, but I didn't understand at the time. I was a gangly child. I was scared. He was tall.
I cried.
And then all of a sudden, about 8 hours into the 8 hours, he was there.
Barack Obama.
He was beauty. He was grace. He was
Barack Obama.
He walked into the room. He wasn't wearing a Reebok.
I noticed. I began to feel like I made a mistake.
My mother took pictures of him shaking hands with others. Rich people, CEOs, none of whom were wearing Reeboks. And at the very end, Obama began to leave. I was happy enough to embrace his presence, but my parents were not happy. They needed more.
Mr. Obama?
They called, and they pointed to me. Of course, Obama said. He was so nice, I thought, and then it hit me. Oh no, I thought.
Oh yes.
My parents thought at some point probably, I'm Obama, Obama thought most likely. And I was going to meet Obama up close and personal. Obama!
Barack Obama!
The rest was a blur. The next thing I knew, I was there with Obama. His head was shaking, my Obama didn't know. I did, I thought. I did it. I lied. I lied to the President of the United States. I pulled it off. The greatest lie in history. The greatest heist. I didn't even know what a heist was.
I was 13.
Oh, so you're in sixth grade then, Obama said. Shit, I was so close. Shit, what do I do, I thought. The journey's not all over. Not over. The nightmare goes on. What do I say? I opened my mouth to say yes.
No.
What the fuck, I think?
No. I'm in seventh grade.
Because I was. Maybe he won't know, I thought. But he did.
Obama's been around the block.
Obama knows what's up.
So, you're ahead of your class, then, he said.
I wasn't. I failed basic math at least twice by this time. Yes, I said.
Just wanting the nightmare to be over, just wanting the lie to end, for Obama to call me out of my shit and arrest me, to spend the rest of my youth locked away in a prison where I couldn't hurt anyone anymore with my lies. I waited for the arrest.
Obama!